In this brief video, I'm going to introduce you to graduate studies in the Management Information Systems area group. I've organized the content in this video to help you answer some key questions that you're now facing as you're trying to decide what graduate program is right for you. Some of the questions that are facing you right now are, which school do I go to? What program is right for me? What domain or area is one that I'm interested in? And maybe what faculty members might I be interested in working with? I've organized the content in today's video to try to help answer some of those questions, and in particular, what program here at Smith, if Smith is the school that you're targeting, might be right for you. So some of those, what I'm going to look at in terms of the content is this the right program, or which is the right program for you? Introduce you to our faculty and some of the research areas that they're looking into, and give a flavor of some of the research topics that some of our recent students have endeavored, and give you a summary to help you, again, try to make that final decision of what program is right for me. So I'm going to tell you about what we look for in our MSc and PhD applicants. In terms of interest, we're looking for students that are interested in research, that have a curiosity and an appetite for looking into how systems and information can help bring value to organizations. And on the flip side, trying to be wary of the challenges and the costs, and even the dark side of information technology in businesses. The other thing you want to understand is the types of backgrounds that we're looking for. And the good news is they're actually quite varied. So if you have a background in business or commerce with some sort of focus on information systems, or in computer engineering, computer science, perhaps information science is an area, as well as other disciplines like even healthcare, education, maybe with some sort of specialization in management and administration. So there's lots of areas that our students actually come from, so that's a good news perspective. It's also important to look at what we're interested in MSc and PhD applicants specifically. So for MSc applicants, we're really interested in looking at students who are interested in pursuing a PhD afterwards. One thing that's important to note about our MSc is that it is very different from our MBA program, which would be more industry, professionally experience oriented. So if you're interested in research and pursuing a PhD afterwards, the MSc would be the right fit for you. In terms of our PhD applicants, some of the background that we're looking for, we do need you to have an MSc in either information science or computer science or other disciplines as one of the criteria. And then you're also planning to pursue an academic career after finishing your PhD. That is, you want to work at a university as a professor and conduct research. In terms of the attributes that we're looking for in our students, the first is that you want to be smart, hardworking students. The MSc and the PhD program are challenging intellectually, and the workload are quite challenging. So you need to be smart, hardworking, but also have this intellectual curiosity. So that you're looking at trying to solve puzzles, you're looking at identifying new puzzles, and trying to get new insights into solving those puzzles. And above all else, being research oriented. So, you know, looking at these with a research mind, with a research eye, and trying to, craft these research papers as part of that overarching process. In terms of the types of research that we do here at Smith in the MIS area, another thing that's important to note, as much of our research is very behaviorally oriented as opposed to technically oriented. So focusing on management topics that have a behavioral sort of spin to them, very much looking at embedding theory in what we're doing. So we're often looking at the cross-sections of systems and technology as they interact with organizations and individuals and psychology and behavioral theories and marketing, economics. So there's lots of sort of cross-disciplinary work going on, but again, above all else, it's very management focused, behavioral focused, as opposed to developing these new technologies. There is some of that done, but the main focus is more on this behavioral component of things. Some of the topics that we look at in the MIS area in terms of our own faculty are things like looking at environmental sustainability and IT, looking at digital technologies and transformations and what innovations organizations are doing, looking at healthcare and IT. How can information technology help healthcare innovate and become more effective and efficient? projects and agility. So how are organizations completing projects in a more agile fashion and having those projects be successful? Looking at the dark side of technology. So what are some of those negative consequences of using technology in our everyday lives and in organizations? As well as looking at analytics and artificial intelligence. That's one of my particular areas of research, but looking at that and what does the future look like? How do people make sense of information and make better decisions with analytics and artificial intelligence? And at the core of everything, looking at how technology and systems are developed and implemented in organizations. So if the programs and the topics sound interesting, keep watching. I'll now tell you about our faculty and what each of our research areas entails so you can see if there's something that interests you in terms of working with one of us or many of us. So the first faculty member I'm going to introduce you to is Dr. Shamel Adas. Dr. Adas looks at the individual level of research, and I'll introduce the levels of research that each of us looks at because that will at least give you a broad overview of the types of challenges that and problems that we're looking at. Dr. Adas looks at topics such as techno stress, interruptions, and the impact that has on individuals in the organization. So in much of this, he's looking at that negative consequences, more of the dark side of information technology use. He also looks at IS privacy and security and healthcare and information systems and how systems can be used to help promote better health outcomes in that. Next, I'll talk about Dr. Catherine Broman. Dr. Broman looks at more the organizational level as well as even the industry level in terms of maybe looking at ecosystems of organizations and their use of digital technology. Dr. Broman looks at systems management with a specific interest in healthcare and systems improvement and how, again, similar to Dr. Adas, how that can be used to help promote healthy outcomes in patients and nudge people into better health behaviors. Dr. Broman also looks at technology-enabled value co-creation and customer-patient centricity. So very focused on the customer. Dr. Broman brings in a lot of marketing theories into that line of work. She also looks at the evolution towards open technology platforms. Next, I'll introduce you to Dr. Yolan Chan. Dr. Chan, who you might have also watched in other videos on the website, is our Associate Dean of Research and our PhD and MSc programs. Dr. Chan's research is at the organizational level, looking typically at strategic level of analysis. Dr. Chan looks at digital innovation, frugal innovation, and strategic alignment are some of her core topics that she looks at, dynamic IT alignment and in organizations as well. Next, I'll introduce you to Dr. Brent Gallup, who's an emeritus professor here at Smith School of Business. And I want to introduce you to Dr. Gallup because although he's retired, he plays a very big part in our group still, and you may see him at many of our seminars when we bring in guest speakers. So I wanted to introduce you to Dr. Gallup. A lot of his work in the past has been focused on the group level analysis and really understanding how technology can be used to help groups make better decisions and avoid some of the cognitive biases that groups are prone to in making decisions and being more creative and brainstorming, that sort of thing. Next, I'll introduce you to myself, and I'll talk about the current research that I'm engaged with, but you'll also see on the slides that there's a couple of other areas that I have researched in the past in terms of projects and also looking at environmental sustainability. Currently, though, I'm looking at artificial intelligence and specifically looking at how can individuals make sense of AI output in the context of very complex decision making. So as individuals look at this AI output, how are they making sense of that? What are the cognitive biases involved? And really looking at in the future, how will humans and AI collaborate to help make these complex decisions in a way that is more effective and successful. So really has some important implications overall in the future for not only how we work, but also how we interact with other professionals. So a lot of interesting societal impacts with what I'm looking at. Next, I'll introduce you to Dr. Sandy Staples. Dr. Staples works at the individual level as well as the team level. Right now, he's doing a lot of work on information systems technology and environmental sustainability. He also looks at working virtually in teams and agility in IS projects as well. In the past, he's also looked at managing and sharing knowledge. Lastly, I'll introduce you to Dr. Jane Webster. Dr. Webster looks at the individual primarily and has in the past looked a little bit at the team level. Similar to Dr. Staples, Dr. Webster has looked at information technology and environmental sustainability and how IT can help with those really complex environmental sustainability issues that we're currently faced with and will be faced with for the foreseeable future. She's also looked at the impacts of technology on employee work and the influence of human-computer interaction on playfulness and work-related consequences. So some of her work in the past has been on the idea of flow. She's also recently published a paper on gamification in our top journal, MIS Quarterly. So now that I've introduced you to our faculty and the research that each of us looks at in those particular research areas, I'm going to give you a glimpse into some of our students and some of the topics that they have looked at so you can kind of get a sense of, are any of these topics things that you can envision yourself studying? First, I'm going to tell you about the recent MSc summer research projects and the topics within those, so you can get a feel of some of the topics students have looked at in the past in those summer research projects. So the first one looks at looking at IT and looking at pro-environmental sustainability behavior. So how can IT modify or change or impact those behaviors? Next, there's a study that looks at firm agility and performance and how IT can impact that. Next, we have a study that looks at identifying the design principles for requirements determination in IT projects. So again, something at the project level. Next, we have a study that looks at negative emotions and their role in social network switching behavior. So again, looking at social networks as the focus there. And lastly, on this slide, you'll see that there's a topic that looks at automatic medication refill and how IT can be used in that area. Next, I'll talk about some of the PhD dissertation topics that we've had with our recent PhD graduates. One of the topics looks at demand-side activities of electricity service providers, so looking at smart grid. So again, something on environmental sustainability and IT in the context of smart grids. Next, we have looking at information systems control alignment in organizations and what that entails. Next, we have looking at IT projects and how project members in ISD projects, how their mental models are affected, how they're developed, and how they affect the management of ISD projects. Next, we have a topic that looks at frugal digital innovation and how IT can affect the frugal innovation in developing countries or smaller communities. Lastly, we have a study that looks at the role of information systems in strategic improvisation and turbulence and how IT can be used in that improvisation context. So to sort of recap and summarize things, I wanted to kind of leave you with some final thoughts on why choose MIS and why choose Smith. So at Smith, we offer a really a nice way to combine an MSc and the PhD seamlessly, and you will have heard more about that in some of the other videos, so I won't go into more depth, but that's one advantage, is that you can blend that MSc into the PhD program. We also have internationally known MIS scholars that are leading in our fields and publishing in our top journals. And lastly, we have support. You'll see, as I mentioned in some of the topics, support for interdisciplinary research that's really trying to solve some of these really tough puzzles that are plaguing us right now. And how can we bring technology to bear to address those very complex problems in organizations and society at large? So I hope that you found that the video and what we've talked about today very helpful in making your decision. And good luck with that decision. Thank you.